The city of Los Angeles has a problem. A real problem. They've got a monkey problem. A human monkey problem.
Yeah! Woo!
The city a month ago debuted the 6th Street Bridge. It alleviates traffic. It makes it easier to get from one side of town to the other. On top of that, it gives you a skyline of downtown LA. And people are also allowed to walk across the bridge to enjoy the sights and sounds of downtown LA. But unfortunately, the beauty and joy of the bridge has been disrupted by the onslaught of monkey behavior. And the monkeys have done everything they can to make this new bridge, this new project, a hazard. They're basically vandalizing it, tagging it, climbing on it, street racing, cutting off the street, endangering lives, crashes. In less than a month, they have already done so much damage that the city council are now coming up with different ways and new laws and ordinances to put in to distract the monkeys or anybody who wants to become a monkey to try to make them or stop them from doing everything that the bridge was not made to do. The bridge is there for citizens to have some sort of pride and joy, but that's not what's happening. Basically, it's a microcosm of the takeover that the monkeys have done in the City of Angels. Right after George Floyd was murdered, there was a swell of social justice marches throughout LA. During these peaceful social justice marches, there was the birth of the monkeys, of the band of monkeys developed underneath. It was like a small groundswell of monkeys started to percolate and formulate. And before you know it, they were vandalizing any and every retail shop and store throughout Los Angeles. That was summer of 2020. We are now summer of 2022. And it has expanded. The monkeyness has expanded to the point where it is completely out of control. Smashing grabs of jewelry stores, robbing people in the middle of the day, out on the street during the week, daytime hours, running up to them, snatching their whatever they have in their hand, telling them to give them their jewelry, telling them to give them their wallet. That on top of running into stores, taking stuff, running out, running into people's homes repeatedly, same neighborhoods, robbing houses from house to house, even with the police descending down on these monkeys over the last few years. They are still finding ways. Creatively, I give them that. They are very creative. They have found ways to continue to rob and steal, hurt, sometimes murder innocent people just so they can capitalize on retail goods, jewelry, money, whatever it may be. And it's a problem that the city of LA has no answer for. And it's unfortunate. It really is unfortunate because outside of that, City of LA has got 3 to 4 issues that are pendingly, disgustingly sickly as it relates to homelessness, the cost of living, police car chases, bad driving, culminating into horrific accidents where people are dying. The crime rate is bad out here. The murder rate is bad out here. So what we have is that mixed in with the groundswell, the bubbling up of the band of monkeys that came out of the pandemic, and the city is suffering. People can't even peacefully enjoy a day, a weekend, whatever it may be out here, without at least thinking in the back of their mind, there could be some bullshit that can go down at any point in any time. And that's where we are at. And the 6th Street Bridge Project is only just a small sample. But I thought it was important to connect the dots because this is what is happening out here. And it's not good. It's not good. It's bad. It's horrible. And I can only think that is some of the reason why people are moving out of California at a speedy vamoose rate on a daily basis. People are gone. And I don't blame them. Because who would want to live in an environment and a culture that only seems to be getting worse? The band of monkeys are on the loose and they can't be stopped.
Subscribe, follow, share.
So you can run and tell that.